Sitaram, everybody. Let's all stand as we begin this evening with aarti and mantras. As you get set to welcome the Lord with prayer and aarti, today is one day, this Ekadasi, this day for Lord Vishnu, comes one day for the entire year. This particular Ekadasi, Kamada Ekadasi, a person will have to wait till next year now to get to do prayer, to listen to Katha on this night. People throughout the world have been fasting, feeding people, sharing food, feeding dogs in particular. A wonderful day for this type of prayer. We tonight get to welcome Mahavishnu, all his Leela, all the Devtas, as we get set to do this course taken from Anand Rama. Put your hands to your chest, close your eyes, and in your own way, dear Lord, thank you for the opportunity. In your time, in your holy time, I get to listen to your discourse, I get to do puja. Thank you for that. Jai Jagadish Hari, Mahavishnu, I sing your praises. Sajam cha varti sanyuktam grahina yojitam mayam deepam grihana devesham trailokya timirapaham. Everybody together. Jai Jagadish Hare Swami, Jai Jagadish Hare
Mata Jano Ki Sangat Mata Jano Ki
Jai Jagadish Hare, Swami Jai Jagadish.
Let's pray together, everybody.
Om Gajananam.
Everybody, lift your voice tonight.
Kapete Jambo. Umasutam sho
Harinashanarkam
Namami Viganeshwara
Parvampajam
Sarvamangalamangalye
Shive Sarvartasarike
Sharanye
Trayambike
Narayani
Namostute
Gurur Brahma
Gurur Vishnu
Gurur Devo
Maheshwara
Gurur Sakshat
Param Brahma
Tasmai Shri
Guruve
Shivaya, everybody.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Your turn.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Everybody.
Om Namah Shivaya.
Rama Rama Bhadrama Rama Chandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya
Sitaya Pate Namaha.
Jyavar Ramachandra ki jai.
Devotees, please have your seat. Make yourself comfortable. If you came in after when we started Sitaram again, before we go further, make sure your phone on silent. Some of you, I believe, got a little red flag. There will be fear. What did they give you that for? Let me be honest. It seems out of place. Me I know what to do with that body. Don't let me hide, eh? I ashamed to even lift that thing. More than my nose ashamed. But for all the adults here, when they go panorama, when they go with Nicholas in election time and the waving flag that time, all pride, all strength now in the, what this flag represents. Tonight we have a wonderful, wonderful discourse. But I would like to, in the precis for it, in the introduction, do you know the history of flags came from Indian dharma, Indian culture? In today's world, we use flags in many instances. In the Olympic Games, you know which country a person comes from, not from by the uniform, but by the flag they represent or they wear on their body. If we go Shagaramas and we go looking for the boats, you could see where a ship is coming from based on the flag it's flying. If a Chiren, you will know a pirate ship from the pirate flag. We know the destination, we know where it's coming from. It gives so much information. If somebody were to ask somebody here, your red, white, and black flag, the red represents something, the black represents something, the white represents something. I don't know about now, but I remember they used to teach us that in school. And the tenets of that flag is what it is. When somebody says, I'm a citizen, I bow, I pay honor, when I pledge allegiance to that flag, I pledge allegiance to the message behind what that flag represents. The red represents this, and I abide by that message. So when I see the flag going up on the pole, I will stand at attention. That is what we are taught as citizens of this country. In any country, it's the same. But the entire idea of flag being symbolic of message originated how many years ago in Indian culture, when they would take to the battlefield and you wanted to signify the archers or the people with the mukdar or the infantry on horseback, they would have a different color flag. So when the person, because remember, you don't have a mic. Think how you communicate on the Mahabharat war field when you cannot yell, Nicholas, you and your set, come forward. There's no mic system. There's no cell phone. There's no radio wave to say, come, send these guys in front. That's like what you see in the airplane. When the plane is coming to park, in today's world, they use a light inside of a plastic shell. But initially, it used to be flags. And you would see the person flagging down, turn left, turn right, turn a little more, and you're lining up with the car park. Sometimes when you're parking your car, you wish you had the assistance. In the same way, the flag was used there to assist in this example. Imagine me and Nicholas here in front, and we want somebody from the back. That set in the back, you all come forward. So if you have a blue flag with your section, we'll wave the blue flag, and that meant come forward. People with the green flag, stay back. People with the yellow flag, stay back. Let the blue people come forward. And in this way, in our culture, when you hear about war, just to imagine thousands of people lined up on the Mahabharat war. How did they communicate? Who is going to take the battlefield first? Who is going to come second, etc.? This communication was always used because of flag. Or what in prayer, Baba would say, dwaj or dwaja. The message that this flag is sending in our life today is usually not the message of war, but actually the message of peace. And it, now in today, in Trinidad culture, the flag is causing a little confusion. I don't know if this ever happened. Where, Nick, where is this plant flag? In your house? Yeah, where is put it on? I go in and build my house. Where to put it on? My grandmother would tell me to put it. No, my godfather would tell me that. But my mother, what my mother would tell me? Had to go to the front. Agreed? That is the tradition. Let me use the word tradition. When I ask you, where do you plant your flags? Well, Babs, we plant it to the front. Do you know why? Trinidad culture. Trinidad culture, do you know why? Your Hindu text, the Vastu Sastra, says plant it in the northeast corner. That is the rule. So in case the northeast corner is to the back, if you ever went by somebody's house and you see the jandi into the, how they plant that to the back, boy? That is where the northeast corner, or what in English we would say the God corner. That is the spot for that. When you are building your house and you are allocating, this is the kitchen, this is the bedroom, it have rules. Because when they were tying Vastu down to the earth, Vastu is the energy, the devata that live in the earth. When Brahma had finished creating, whilst he was nodding away, a devata fall out from his nostril with the hot air, breathe out of this person. But he born with this hunger now. Anything you see, imagine you have a table with fruit, he eating the fruit, he eat the bowl, he eat the table, he eat the chair, and so he going, nonstop. So they ask him, what is this? What kind of creature are you? What you I just make the whole universe. You can't do this. He says, hold up, I'm a devata. You're my father. You're Brahman. You created me. He says, so what is your name? He says, my name is Vastu, and I'm very hungry. And you have to feed me. So they end up telling him, no, you can't eat everything here. You can't do that. You cannot do that. And they end up in a little argument as the Katha went to. Lord Vishnu, all the devatas fight, beat. And eventually, imagine this square piece of paper. Let me just call this the cadastral. This is your lot of land. If you ever see Vastu, Vastu looks like a man who is folding his foot and he's trapped in a square, a rectangle like this. So in some books, you'll see him. And on his back, you will see, imagine me and Nicholas holding down a fella in a square with a fisherman's net, just for children to understand. Understand what I say? We take a net and we trap him there. The square is your piece of land. What they did was they brought verse 2 onto the earth and they trapped him using this net. So on this piece of land, on the north side is one deity, on the southern, on the north is Lord Vishnu, on the south side is Agni, on the east, west, deities, and they pinned him there. Because Lord Vishnu is on the north side, they say that that is your deity corner. So when you're building your house, northeast corner, you don't put a bedroom there where husband and wife will sleep. Where children are going to be made, do not put that in your northeast corner. Argument from start to finish. Put it where the crib is, put the living room in the northeast corner, put your prayer room in the northeast corner. That's the best place for it. Everything will run really good. In your northeast corner, you put your jandi because of that same thing. But in Trinidad culture, where you have a mixture of religion, so then the next question Nicholas is going to ask me, so how come if in front of my house is the south, how come did we put the flag there? Why is that? What you saying, Pandit? You have to understand your history. In Trinidad, there were a mixture of Sabha. We know Mahasabha. Agreed? Right. In Mukarapur Street, I believe, I took out money, I think 56, but I could be mistaken on the year. There, just like how we have Shiv Dharam Sabha and different Sabha, there were about four different Sabha that came to a meeting in Mukarapur Street. And from the four of them, they made a conglomerate that came together to form Mahasabha, the great Sabha, the great gathering. That's the history of that organization, in a nutshell. When they formed the organization, they says, listen, we will not know which house belongs to a Hindu brother or a Hindu sister. The homes are built the same. Everybody know how the house was built in those days. You had a little gallery, a living room, a kitchen, bedroom, 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 and then later on came the toilet room. So the structure was similar for everybody, all race, all religion. So the question came up, how will we identify who our brothers are? Who our Hindu brothers are? And the Mahasabha said, let them plant the jandi to the front. Let them put the flag to the front, regardless the direction, contrary to the text. But it was a means of surviving cross-cultural difference. Because why? When we go to Jamaica, and you hear Rasta and Rasta and Rasta, the Rastafarian race and religion that is propagated in Jamaica started from all the Maharaj that came from the boat. For all the middle-aged, my age people and older, all you remember it had a singer named Maxi Priest. All you remember that name? Singer, popular singer. His proper name is Maharaj. Their family was Pandit. But because now they did not hold on to their identity, and this is the trouble. The people from the boat came with, yeah, how do you establish culture? We can cook our food, we can speak our language, and we maintain our garb, our clothing. But slowly, the clothing eroded. In our culture in Trinidad, do you remember before the trade show how difficult it was to get Indian clothes? You couldn't walk in everywhere and just go and buy. You remember if somebody, like a wedding, somebody, I'm planning a wedding with somebody on the phone coming down here. So Baba, we bound to get the sari, whether it is give the girl, you know, they bring in from boy side to girl side. For all the senior people here, you remember that sari had so much of worth that the boy side is giving you this very expensive cloth, this material that you couldn't get. Nowadays, those same type of shea material reach $25. They don't want to wear that anymore, Pandit. That is garbage. We're not wearing that. The sari come, but in Jamaica, to use an example, they couldn't get the clothes. So people from generation to generation, I don't know if it's happening here in Barpur, Pinal. Remember when grandmother used to sew, and then mother sew a little bit, And now the granddaughter, like my niece, cannot spell sewing machine, much less to put it on. In that example, for the people who used to sew Jama Jora and all the wedding outfits, sew from scratch, the art of sewing it was lost. So where are you going to get when you cannot buy and now I cannot make? So you know what? We are going to wait. In Trinidad, at a time when there was a problem for clothes, politicians at the time wanted to help maintain the Indian culture. Let me just say the Indianness, the link to India. And one way they did that was to give, I want to use the word subsidy with what? The visa, so that these people could import the clothes, they could come, they could set up and sell, as they do in other parts of the world. Hence, the trade show was for. So today, we tend to be quite up to date. Shah Rukh Khan wear one kurta. Next week, it in the jag. But in the clothes, it have many examples, and the food, well, you may know about Indian food. But it have many examples where we do lose our culture. Not only Baba talking about putting the flag to the front, but the verse 2 says otherwise. When you understand what you are doing, you realize where we have to re-educate ourselves as information. Because what's the problem? Our texts were locked up in Sanskrit. Our elder pundits did their best to hold these people, to hold the faith, to propagate faith. When you see an older pundit may not know the intricacy of all the mantras and the texts that a younger pundit have. Remember, in those days, they didn't have Google. You did not have that access where you could click something on Amazon and it reach into your door. You had to use one sank. And mind that song, if you're puhar like me, where the bag does hit everything in the car and it knock in and sank this get, if you could see this, sank this get window and all kind of thing. You would hold this from your grandfather and mind this, because one day my grandson will have to blow this. There's no shop to go and buy a sank. In our culture today, we are undergoing different types of corruption of information. Follow me. You ever went to the trade show and buy one of the nice pants suit or the kurta suit and the kometa pants? I seen it, eh? And as you sit down for your prayers, grr. Do you know why that happens? That is not from Hindu culture. That design is not made for your knees to bow like that. Okay. But the problem is, when you don't know the value of what you have, you'll lose it. How many people, for example, could tie their dhoti? Or tie their sari? The people in Jamaica lost it long time. People ill speak them. They are of a different race, Baba. Truthful, they have your race, genetically. They are very similar. They came on the boat. Everybody else came from slavery. But when you start to forget how to cook your curry, in our lifetime, in my generation, I remember nobody knew moringa. If you ask anybody, what is saijan? Remember there was a time you couldn't get poi bhaji and you couldn't get saijan and you could... Children today maybe know a little bit about saijan, because when it was researched by other people and it became popular in the Western world, moringa soap, moringa water, etc. Now we have to get back that plant. Now it has value. So now when people could break the leaves and sell it by the pong in the market in Trinidad, I have to plant that tree in my yard. I have to have moringa tea. In fact, the Rambaros boy, who is the CEO of KFC, Hindu fella, if you ever go in your grocery and you see Rambaros tea, pay attention, you'll see. That is his pet project. That is his garage. He makes tea in what we just call them 5 gallon bucket and thing, patch it, mash it, and sell it out of hobby. So that his people, his words, his people could get the tea that we have in our vein, but we don't follow it too much. Mommy, I remember telling my own mother, Mom, me want a stick to carry, you know. But when you start to hear about the benefit, now, Keshav, I eat moringa today. Now you want what popular. If somebody were to ask you, what is the sweets? What is the Hindu sweets? What Lakshmi Mata want? Anybody? Nick, tell him. Barfi, and? Barfi song Hindu? It's song Hindi? No. No, no, babe. It's song. But Lakshmi Mata ain't no parditi. Ain't no parditi. Mark Barfi. Barfi is an Islamic recipe. Yeah. But remember, we are mixing. So my neighbor, oh God, Nick, you remember you did this. You remember when all them tanti them had dead, how they used to tick down curtain and turn around pitiye? A long time example. Before you, right. For every elder here, you remember when somebody passed away, and if your mother-in-law tell you, turn around the pitiye, imagine me and Nicholas stand up in your house in a pitiye and we pose nice. Somebody dead turn wrong we pity, like if we pity do you something. What are you doing that for? You say here people say, well, the place unclean. Wipe down all the window, wash the curtain. If you want to wash your clothes, nothing wrong. But know that that is rooted in Islam. Islam says, when the angels of God come through the door, if they are met with eyes, they turn and leave. For that reason, you will see a picture of Jesus Christ. You will see a picture of Ram, Krishna. But you wouldn't see a picture of Allah. You will see the name of God. But never a picture. Never a picture. Never illustration with eyes. So in those homes, those people who follow that rhetoric, they wouldn't have pictures of family members, etc. Or if you ever see somebody sell a picture frame where it has like a door effect to close, that is how that is made. They don't have mirrors either. When, imagine, I sure all you can see this. I live in down the road. I hear the fella up the road tick down all the pit here. Well, I go in and do that too. The point of saying this is, it's so amazing how Hindus get captivated when people do things. That sometimes in all these examples, you don't know what you're doing. You don't know why you're doing it. What you're doing, you're buffing your children. I sure it has somebody here get buff. Ma, where we turning around the picture? Shut your mouth and don't ask me nothing. I sure somebody guilty of that. Another example, just to hammer the point home. When somebody die again, it's a nice easy example, funeral. The person dead. You start a light. I know the Hindu thing talk about the kalsa or the parai. Man, woman, who die. That is usually our go-to step. Light that dear. I remember one time, the person said, somebody like you who I could guide straight. Where's the best thing, Pandit? When to do the funeral? Well, if you get through with the certificate today, tomorrow morning we could do funeral. So Pandit, how we could do funeral so quick? How we ain't gonna keep our week a little weak? Everybody go feel you know, a hurrying to burn my mother. But let me go again. Hindu, when is the best time to do your funeral? Soon as possible. The one thing Hindu and Muslim agree on in this regard, do not delay. But the Muslim hold it. It have nothing like who abroad coming, where you coming this year, dead. Who, when they was living, that was the time to see them. Not now. You're suffering that soul. If you understand this point, if you make this mistake, let me just touch on it. The soul jump out of the body. Where to go? Who to go by? I have family up and down the road. You see where the dear lighting? Go there. Stay there. Remain there. Wherever that lighting, once it lighting, stay there. The soul watching how Nicholas bawling, oh God, mommy, oh God, mommy, oh God, mommy. poor thing want to go back in the body to hug up the nephew. But suppose the soul see, well, you don't pass away. We love you, but we love you enough to do the prayers. And what's supposed to happen? Swiftly. Do the sanskar, do the antishti, do the funeral, so that the soul could begin the ritual, begin the journey. But what we just do, we just want to wait and do this thing called wake. But Nicholas, I just get confused. You just tell me I had to start a fast, funeral coming. But for wake here, and it is happening Mohes Road, be honest. And we just had to take our little thing. No? True? It is happening Mohes Road, hush. I had to take a little thing and I had to knock drum and knock table, celebrate, right? Play games of card. But where it come from, Nick, dying we culture? No. The Indian who used to be the indentured worker, working in the cane field, saw the white English or Irish landowner. And they used to emulate up to now, it how old people, if you're married a Negro, I'll kill she. But if you're married white, that's acceptable. White, you can't go wrong. When the white man come by your house, that's a good thing. He do something like God sent. So in Irish culture, they tip the bottle and they say, this is for the fallen soldier. All ever hear about that? You ever do that one, Nick? Where they throw the rum? They celebrate the dead by knocking drum, playing games of chance, and singing and making merry. But that doesn't fit in our culture. But we see them do it, so we went and we say, right, let me do it. Till today we do that madness. Till today we follow that type of broken rules. And the soul of the person who die, that person has to suffer. Think about the person waiting 1 week, 2 weeks for somebody to reach home. And the soul is waiting, grieving to go, to come, and trying to get back in the body. But trouble licks is what Gary Pran says. But I am not studying the person who died, you know, I'm studying myself. I had to make sure and wait to please this one and please that one. That is not how Hindu funeral is supposed to be. Tonight, as we get into our discourse, let me agree, it have a lot of things we just do. In the example of the flag, it have many examples of things we just do that we don't know why we just do it. Everybody understand what I'm saying? All right, let me get our next example. One last one. When you're going to build roof, as I said the first night, you just check Patra to make sure Panchak is absent. If Panchak is running, you cannot, in a safe way, in a healthy way, get through the roof if Panchak is running. Panchak is 5 days in the Patra. So you wait until it pass. When that is passed, you put up them little flag like where you have in your hand. It means something. I'm not too sure what it means. And the person who is too sure what it means is going to offer alcohol by it. All you ever see people do that? I hear people is offer the same alcohol when they dig in grave. Same red flag, eh? And they just had to wet their hand and bathe the shovel in the punching. And in the same breath, when them Tassa man had to go and play. You watch my nephew smiling because he just played Tassa. But nowadays, as I'm talking about it, when they understand the craziness that we just have people doing. Because if you're doing Satwik prayer, you're doing Satwik prayer with your pundit by the baby, you just bring alcohol and offer it by your red flag when you go to offer the dar. No pundit. That is not of our tradition. That is not the parampara or the tradition we follow. But what does happen? How you say it, Nick? The day say? You ever hear somebody explain that? And they say you just have to put it so. And them tell me to put it, and every tanti guilty of that. Do it, I see tanti up the road, do it, yaji, do it so. Why, ma? Shut up. So in an age where young people today getting more and more educated, information is sharing regular, pundits, I using myself, pundits have to know what they're saying. be able to explain yourself. Otherwise, you are going to lose that child. We cannot follow blindly craziness, traditions that have no sense in it. Because when they go to read and they understand what it is they're doing, just like tonight, we're going to understand that little red flag in your hand. Why? If somebody tell you, raise your flag, you shouldn't shame. They shouldn't shame. The day you go and you have to do it in a political rally, or you go to listen to music and you want to raise the flag and jump and rave and everything, and you understand the value of your flag, then I want my cricket team to win, raise your flag. Guyana come here, they can outflag we. We had to outflag them. In many examples, you understand what you hold to that flag. But you have a flag in your hand right now, and you ain't know what it mean, the value, and you have very little attachment to it. Let me be honest. You get a flag in your hand. Did anybody bow to the flag? Think what I say. Be honest with yourself. Pundit bless them thing it offer by the baby, so that when it reached by you, it must have God on it. How much are you about it? But we don't want nobody else desecrate with flag, you know. Somebody pull down your flag when you had jag and you're planting flag side the road and somebody pull it down, that garbage. You know you're vexed. And you wouldn't hold and touch your own flag to your furry. Let me enter now to understand this flag thing. Where are we upon the talking about? We enter into Anand Ramayana. Anand Ramayana is a text written by Valmiki Ramayana. Valmiki had written his original Valmiki Ramayana, and he felt as if he did not do justice to the peace of the Katha, what happens after the war is won. So it begins with August Muni telling Sri Ram, you have to go and atone for your sin, you know. That same discussion where we had last night, how the Munis them came and they went to meet Sri Ram to congratulate him. In that conversation, before Sita Mata come back, says, Prabhu, don't forget him. When you go home, you have to do something called praschit. Praschit is like, for example, Gayatri or giving salt in Dan, different things, so that the mistakes I make, dear God, don't lay it be on my shoulder. I want forgiveness. I want to come out of that sin. There are many examples of that. He said, praschit. You just tell me congratulations for winning the bad man. And now do everybody a favor. What you talking about now? Somebody tell you this. What you gonna say? In doing your duty against sin? That way you telling me? I'm a kshatriya, I destroy bad. Now I get sin. That way you want to put on me? And Sri Ram asked him, why? Why did you say that? Let's enter into our discourse tonight, everybody. We are in Manohar Khan, chapter 18.
Tuma bade bir balwan, Mahavir Bajrangi.
Tuma bade bir balwan, Mahavir Bajrangi.
Main daro tumharo dhyan, Mahavir Bajrangi. पवन पुत्र अंजनी दुलारे रघुनंदन के प्राण प्यारे जय 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 कृष्ण रोहत अर्जुन स्कंदा ते पटिये आतिथि पर ये आनंद करुणा ये दक्षिणा ये आति
महावीर बजरंगी मैं दारो तुम्हारो महावीर बजरंगी.
This is now Sri Ram had left the earth. And this particular part, they want to understand the value of that dwaj, kapi dwaj. Kapi dwaj is the flag of the monkey. Dwaj, dwaja means flag. Kapi means the monkey. Why is that valuable? Last night when we were closing this course, Hanuman says, from the flag of Arjun, from the flag of Arjun in the Mahabharat war, I will screel and I will give you the strength to win. That from that dwaj, from that flag, I will give you the strength. That when you have work to do, from that flag, I will give you the power. That wherever that flag is flying, you will be successful. Victory will be yours. So now, where's the history behind that? How that come so relevant? He says, not in Ram Janam, Krishna Janam. Krishna is on the earth and he has guided Arjun to go and do Tirat, pray to Lord Shiva and get all the weapons now. And Arjun reached in the southern tip of India where Rameshwar Jyotirlingam is. And he did a wonderful puja. And now he goes walking by the seaside. And while he's walking, a little discussion is happening unknown to him.
तुम बड़े वीर भलवान महावीर बजरंगी मैं डारो तुम्हारो ज्ञान महावीर बजरंगी रामचंद्र के काज सवारे लंका जाय सिया सिद्ध लायो पायो अमर पर जा धारो तुम्हारो
ज्ञान
जगत गुरु रामेश्वर सेना शिवा भक्त हनुमाना सेना पुण्य अर्जुना ये नातेना तम चर्चा चरा तुम भरे वीर बल
महावीर बजरंगी धारो तुम्हारो
ही जाय सजीवन लायो
When they had to go for the Sajivan, this song is talking about Mahavir Bajarangi, the powerhouse. That when they had to go to get the Sajivan herb, the next verse says, Lakana lal ke pran bachayo, the breath, the pran. Of Lakan, Lakan is Lakshman. You are the one who has to save him. You are the only person who could go and bring that mountain, not just the bush, but the mountain that saved the devotee. You are that great force, oh Hanuman Baba.
Tum hi jaye sajivan layo.
Come on, if you don't know the song, clap for me.
Lakan lal ke pran bachayo. रामा स्वर्णा शर्माता पूर्वा कृत फर ये यम तेरा कथा तेरा तम कृतवे तेरा तम तुरन अर्जुना
तुम बड़े वीर बलवान महावीर बजरंगी मैं जानो तुम्हारो ज्ञान
तुम्हारो ज्ञान
महावीर बजरंगी
मैं डारो तुम्हारो ज्ञान महावीर बजरंगी
पवन पुत्र हनुमान की जय जगत गुरु सो इमेजिन इन वन साइड अर्जुन इज वॉकिंग किकिंग द सन वेटिंग फॉर द प्रेयर इन द टेंपल टू स्टार्ट बैक They do puja in temples in India as if the murti is living. Meaning, we worship him and then we close the curtains so as to give the devta a chance to get rest. So everybody has to vacate the temple. In that time, Arjun goes for a little walk. waiting for the Sunday hour to come, and before the 4 or 5 o'clock hour, when the sun still in the sky but getting ready to go down, they will open back the curtain to give people darshan. Darshan is when I can see with your eyes, the murti. I can see when they're waving the light. We do it. This is why we stand for arti. We are practicing darshanam, that type of bhakti or devotion where I'm using my eyes so the person could watch the satsang here, they could watch from by the bedi, they could watch it in the audience, they could watch it on their television or their device. But I am looking at prayer, and when you get to see the murti of Lord Vishnu for Ekadasi, again the arti. Yani kani chap, and they are going around, they circumambulating the murti with the arti. It says when you walk around the murti 3 times, you burn away this life, past life, the sins that you make via your mouth, your thoughts, and your deeds. But when the murti is against the wall, how are we going to walk around it, Pandit? Circumambulate like this, make circles. This is why we do it like that. The long version, you go outside that door and you walk around and you're coming through maybe a door here. When you see people doing it by the Hanuman Murti up the highway, that is what they're doing. That is why you do it. It is saying that when you walk around the lingam, when you're just going to finish and we're walking around the bedi, that is what allows you to burn away the past sin. It is called praschit karma. Karma that yields benefit by burning away the past sin. Arjun went to take a walk around the mandir, if you understand what happening. And he's talking to Lord Shiva. He's saying, Mahade Baba, please give me all the arrows, all the weapons, all the bhan, all the different arrows, all the different things. War is coming. War is coming. Prepare me for the war. That song very similar to me and you. You know, we have the exam. Dear God, bless the pen and pencil. Saraswati Mata, when the children come, Pandit Anupatapo Sindhur over everything and TK all the pen and pencil, all the book bag, all the book. Bless every utensil that when I go to the battlefield of the exam room, it must work and I must pass and I must get what I want. Good. Jagat Guru is, Jagat is world, Guru is, let me say Godfather. When a person lose parents, when a person lose Diksha Guru, the Pandit who gave you the mantra in your ears. When a person lose Vidya Guru, the school teacher, for example, the dance teacher, the music teacher, and you feel you are left alone, if you ever hear somebody say, I'm an orphan. In Hinduism, there's no such thing as orphan. You can adopt a parent. And if there's nobody around you, your Jagat Guru is Lord Shiva. He is everybody's guru. I have no guru. My guru died. No, you're wrong. You have a guru. It's just you know him. Jagat Guru is the one when you are going wayward, I will let things happen to pull you back, to save you. A mother does it. You ever see somebody crack somebody when they're small? Mommy do it and you know everybody go say? As rough, the child bawling, you know, children is. Oh God, life coming out of them now. And you know what every, let me say, every right-thinking person would say? Wow, that's a mom. That's a dad. Look, discipline. Wow. Discipline is in that Trinidad and Tobago flag. They're living up to that flag, boy. Discipline and tolerance. I'm not showing tolerance for indiscipline. I'm not tolerating your stupidness. I'm showing discipline. When God give me the hat to wear as mother and father, I take my job. And Christian tell you to do your duty. I am not going to pretend I'm something else. I'm going to do my duty and make sure you grow straight. In that example, the mother is doing her job. In Lord Shiva's example, he's hearing the prayer of the devotee. And he says, you want me to help you, but all the demons that could beat you live inside of you. May I say that again? In this person, there is no enemy. He has all the skills, all the training, all the certificate, all the accolades. He has it all. There is nobody that will face him on the battlefield. And he will lose. But when it comes internally now, he is so full of false pride from a practical standpoint. Imagine he watched somebody come on the battlefield against him. Let's say a great fighter in the form of a little child. It happens many times in our discourse. Somebody looks at young fityas and think, oh, this is a stupid child. I will beat this child very easy. I'll outwit this child very easy. You want an example of that? And Lord Shiva thought he could beat Ganesh. And he thought he could outwit him when he had the stick in his Shiv Puran discourse where he cut off the head. And he looked at a child and he thought he could speak down to this child. Who are you to stop me? I am the great Shiva. In that example, just for you to remember, in many examples, when you get it in your head, that person, with them, no. I's a drummer, you is less a drummer, you ain't know how to play drum. You ain't know how to play tasa. You ain't know how to sing. You ain't know how to make parsad. You ain't know how to tie sari. You could tie sari with me. You know what you're saying? Then, when you think like that, you close off, you become very myopic. You close off your ability, you lose the chance to learn something that you could have bettered your skills. To acknowledge that somebody might know something doesn't take nothing from you. Easy to say, hard to realize sometimes. Because everybody have ego. If you really say, boy, you make parsad tonight, your parsad really tastes nice. True, Pandit? Pandit, you ever make parsad with pineapple? No, boy. I never see that. But Pandit, I'll show you tomorrow. And in that moment, instead of it being a competition, it might be a teaching moment. But Arjun, like me in my parsad story, he thinks to himself, he's better than everybody. Where will he learn? And in the moment now, imagine the little child come in front of him to shoot him. He will say, well, you know what? I'm not going to waste my powerful arrow. I'm going to use the one that have no prayers. The little useless one. This person is no form of enemy. Why waste a powerful arrow? And that is where he will meet his death. Lord Shiva says, you are asking me for what you want, but if I give it to you, you'll die. You could imagine, let me just pretend, just for 2 seconds, your God, your Murti at home could appear. And we really had to hear what God would have think or say about me or you. You could imagine how God would have watched we. You only want, you want, you want. What you're willing to change? You want this, you want that, you want the other. Are you willing to better yourself? In this case, we get into hear what God, the other side, is saying. He says, Arjun, if I give you those powerful weapons, because of your character, because of your ego, you wouldn't want to use it in the right time. You'll make a poor decision and you'll die. He says, let me call that person who will become the teacher, the Vidya Guru, the person who will strive, the only person who can work, who can go and pretend he's Brahman to trick Sri Ram, to test Sri Ram, that tester, that type of teacher, I'm going to call him to help Arjun. And who he calls? He calls Hanuman Baba. Lord Shiva summons Hanuman to Kailash. And in a moment's notice, the son of Pawandev reaches. And he bows to Shiv Baba. He says, Baba, tell me, how could I help? How could I serve you? He says, you have some important work for me today, you know. You have to go and teach a lesson. Let's hear what he tells him to go and do. And I want you to consider, just consider, if we could find ourselves in this trouble, and what does God do to teach me and you? Personalize this discourse and see if there is something we could learn. Jai Bole Baba Tab Sharanam. Everybody help me sing. Help me clap. Come on. Jai Bole Baba Tab Sharanam. Jai Samba Sadashiva Tab Sharanam.
Jai Samba Sadashiva Tab Sharanam.
Tadaduna Maruti Prahinam. Punya Punya Marutaye Kapidvaj. Dharana Sutta Payoyatam. Payo Tamatya Narayan. Jaya Bhole Baba Tab Sharanam.
Jaya Bhole Baba Tab
जय बोले बाबा तब शरणम,
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 जय सांब सदा शिव तब शरणम,
जय सांब सदा शिव तब शरणम।
He says, ओ कपि, ओ वानर, ओ हनुमान, गो अपॉन द अर्थ एंड फाइंड दैट ब्रदर ऑफ बीम कॉल अर्जुन। ही इज प्रेइंग आर्डेंटली फॉर डेंजरस वेपन्स, बट दोज वेपन्स विल बी हिज डाउनफॉल। ही इज नॉट केपेबल ऑफ वील्डिंग दोज वेपन्स राइट नाउ। गो, ही हैज टू मच ऑफ फॉल्स प्राइड, ही हैज टू मच ऑफ ईगो एंड अभिमान। गो एंड ब्रेक हिम। You have a Mukdar, and many people think that Mukdar is for other forms and other forms of enemy. But oh, Chiranjeevi, you were made to live long, long more than Ravan. Ravan is no longer here. Who are you going to use that Mukdar for? Use the Mukdar for those hearts that are filled with pride and ego. Go and train your children. Go wherever my devotion, wherever my devotee is, and destroy the false pride in them. Work on them, mill them, mill them, and allow the goodness to raise forward. Hardship, this breed character. When the person under pressure to go from the piece of charcoal, you could become the diamond. But sometimes, most of the times, it is hard to go through a little hardship. Hanuman Baba, go and test them. Go and test them. And for those people that don't pass your test, break them. Allow them to see hardship. Allow them to see difficult times until they learn the path of righteousness. Until they learn what is virtue, what is the correct action, what is the right thing to do. Until that lesson is learned, don't give them an easy time, Hanuman Baba. Go and give Arjun such a situation. Katapada kapi ye kanda, so Arjuna prahiye punaha, yadhi maga Rameshwar he, kapiye vatsala Ram bhaktam, jaya bhole baba,
jaya bhole baba tab sharanam, jaya bhole baba tab sharanam.
Come on everybody, help me sing tonight. He says, Prabhu, I bow to you. I accept the job you give me. And whatever you tell me to do, I will not rebuke it. I am going. If that is my mission, I am going. Hanuman leaves, and in the wink of an eye reaches where Rameshwar Tirath is. Imagine Hanuman Swami coming down from the sky, and Arjuna is right there on the seashore. Hanuman says, oh friend, it is so nice to meet you in this auspicious place, in this great Tirath. What is your name? He says, I am the son of Kunti, younger brother of Yudhishthir. My name is Arjun. Who are you, friend? He says, I am the bhakt. I am the dude of Ram. Sri Ram, who was once the king of Ayodhya, that is my lord. I am his servant. I am his sevak. I am his servant. I am the son of Pawan, Hanuman. Great introduction. Wonderful moment. Imagine somebody say, I is Hanuman. Like last night when Bhim hear that, wow, he recognized that immediately. So the brother of Arjun could know who Hanuman is. He knows. But here with this fellow Pantali. Visham Tatra Ramatvam चपरे पुनः पुनः व्याधाते प्रतिज्ञ कपिध्वज ये याति श्रुत्वा ये अर्जुनायातम जय भोले बाबा
जय भोले बाबा तब शरणम
जय भोले बाबा तब शरणम एवरीबॉडी
जय भोले बाबा तब शरणम
जय सांब सदा शिव तब शरणम
जय सांब सदा शिव तब शरणम
She says who? Who Ram? Which Ram? The same brother of Bhim is going to say this. He says that fool you call Ram, the dotish, stink, stupid person you call Ram who sat on the throne of Ayodhya in that state called Kaushala. That Ram is your God and master. That person who should call himself the great archer, Ram, the one who is in all the pitya had the bow on his shoulder, that Ram, that is your master? Oh, you are such a foolish person for following a person like that. Put this in perspective. Everybody here is like the deer. Big deer, brass deer, small deer, deer. Imagine somebody walking past you on Diwali night and saying, you see that deer lighting there, wasting your time by that jumbi. You wake up and snesty. Half of the people here tonight, Lord, me and where will I light in that deer for? But don't tell me what I doing is garbage. I get very defensive now. I get angry now. Hanuman bites his tongue. Cannot react. Because he went there with a mission, and this is a very obedient fella. When somebody tell you something, you listen. He says, I've come here to himself, eh? I've come here to do the work of Shiva. If I get reactive, in the past when somebody only ill-spoke Ram, I was ready to destroy them. When Ravan ill-spoke Ram, the entire city burnt. But now, this Hanuman will timber down my reaction and I will hold. Not because I could grow like a mountain, I am going to react like this massive powerhouse. I could control myself. I am a follower of Shiva. Shiva is that same Tandav dancing Shiva, Nataraj. But that same Shiva sits down smiling calmly. Watch him right here in your murti. That same man when he danced could destroy this universe. That Shiva is the one who sits calmly. And he thinks about Sri Ram, he thinks about Mahavishnu, and he's listening. He's listening to Katha. He's seeing it unfold as time is passing. He's watching creation, but he does not fall. When somebody says something, does it mean you really have to react? Is it every fight you're going to react? Is it you are going to become so out of control that you become a threat to your family, to the people that you say you love, but you become an embarrassment, you become a shame, you become a letdown, you become the point that everybody, don't tell he nothing now, me I trust how he go react, you know, afraid he, you know. Hanuman says different. I am ready to react. In the past, I was ready to react, but no, I can't do that. I will let down Shiv Baba. He says, true, true. Remember, we talk about true. Watch how you have to talk. He says, true, he's a fool. He's a cheat. That Ram, that great Raghu, that Ram, the one I bow my head to today, I'm hearing it for the first time. He is a liar, a con man. Why are you saying that, brother? Why are you saying that, brother? Maya swargare vrajayatam Ramara molo pitayate Tatra arjuna tat parnata Hasya jivan yeyatav Jaya bole baba Come on everybody!
Jaya
bole baba tab sharana
Jaya
Sambh Sada Shiva Tav Sharanam
Jaya Sambh Sada Shiva Tav Sharanam
He says he calls himself Ram, the incarnation of Mahavishnu. When all the different Ekadasi is being celebrated, when Vijaya Ekadasi, when the different Katha is given, Mahavishnu is incarnated as Ram. He calls himself Mahavishnu, Shankar, Chakra, Gada, Padma, four-handed form, reincarnate, but he could not build the bridge himself.
He could not build the bridge.
Remember the first night we talk about Narad Muni coming to help Sri Ram. When he does Ram, now me brat. We talked about how it is Narad who tells Ram, Vishnu, go up on the earth and you caused me to lose this girl I love. You lost yours. If God is God, why God couldn't save Sita Mata? If God is God, why did he have to become so subservient, he would become dependent on Sugriv and the army of Kapi? When Mahavishnu makes Narad's face look like a monkey, Narad says, you go upon the earth and become desperately in the need of an army of monkey, not one, but all. All will have to be your boss, and you will have to sit outside the city and beg for their help. When Sri Ram waits in one place, Hanuman and Angad and the army goes to the south, to the north, and they are looking for Sita, but Ram is desperate for their help. It is Hanuman, the Kapi, who has to come back and say, Prabhu, I found Sita Mata. When Hanuman Jyotish is created, he says, Prabhu, I figured out a way. I've listened to many munis and I've figured out a way when people have questions, how to get the answer. And Sri Ram says, if you have done this, write it in a book. And when the chakra, if you know about Jyotish, the different chakra are made, and the question, who to marry? Is this the place to work? Should I get this job? Should I buy this house? And when you're passing your finger on the chakra and you're saying your mantra, that comes from Hanuman Baba, because he brings the joy back to Ram. How did that happen? Because he gets a shrap. But Arjun now is saying, this foolish man, he's Vishnu incarnate, but he's dependent on monkeys and squirrel to build, big form, small form, to build a bridge. One like me, I'm just a man, but I am such an archer. I am the greatest archer, in fact, that I could build a bridge for you from bow and arrow. If he was man, he should have built that arrow by himself, that bridge by himself. If you test me, oh friend, I could build such a bridge. Imagine you was Hanuman, and you had to hear that your God, your love is nothing. You're hearing somebody wailing, wailing against your dharma, what you believe in, the principles you live by. How would you feel? Hear what Hanuman tell him.
Akoda sagar yate shun mantro lila ye yate tara deva punya sagar dharma tinya sagar raksha rakshatam jaya bole baba tab
sharanam. Come on everybody.
Jaya bole baba tab sharanam.
Jaya bole baba tab sharanam.
Jaya sambha sadashiva tab sharanam.
He says, you want to make me believe that you could shoot an arrow. Understand, Sharan, what you're talking about? Shoot arrow, and from the tip to the tail, he's joining arrow. He's so good, he could aim and hit the back of the arrow and make one line, two line, three line, until you build a whole bridge from arrows alone. He says, brother, with a smile. Sometimes when the tests come, when the moment come, you see it in your job. When the enemy come and they're attacking you, and they're attacking your faith, when they're attacking your dharma, when they're telling you what, you being faithful in your marriage, you should horn that. Don't take that. You doubt that? You doubt that is happening? Half of the chutney song is telling them, don't take that. The influence. But who influencing Hanuman? Shiva is working on the head. When you see Mahadev Baba had the moon on his head, the moon is interfere with me and your head. When the moon come full, the reason why it is look big, according to Hindu astrology, it is coming closer, incrementally closer to the earth. This is the earth. The moon come closer, so it look big in the sky. The magnetic pull of the moon affects the sea, so the water now, it come like the magnet pulling it up. The sea gets rough and big. When it's not full moon, the moon pull back a little bit, less magnetic pull, the same sea come very calm. The problem with that is we body make with water,
tears, blood, urine, etc. So when the moon come close to some people's head, let me say I have autism, ADHD, I have Down syndrome, I have epilepsy. The moon, the magnet is interfering with my head. I'm feeling like I'm going crazy. You ever hear a husband tell a wife, you're moving like the moon? You're moody like the moon. If I hit you today, you laugh. But when it's full moon time, you're mad. You're getting on bad. You're ready to beat me. That moon interfering with your head. Your God is telling you, I control the moon. I control Chandra Shekara. I control. I am the boss. I am the force that holds on to the moon. And no magnet can interfere here, brother. When you have his force sitting in you, that test you're facing where somebody triggering you to cuss, or triggering you to pull the cutlass, or triggering you to do something you will regret. In this moment, with Starboy, with Shah Rukh Khan, is Hanuman. Shiv is working whole. Don't study where he's saying it. Don't study where he's saying. Don't mind he attacking you. Whole. He says, that's true. Hanuman says, that's true. My brother, it is possible for somebody to build a bridge from Abu Anara. I've never heard such a feat. Could you do that? Tel karma arjunaya pi chitta chitta ye kripa ye atao prithaya te som ye kapidwaj deha hanumantam jaya bole
baba tab sharana jaya bole baba tab sharana
jaya bole baba tab sharana
come on everybody
Jaya Samba Sadashiva Tava
Sharanam.
Arjun said, there's nobody else could do it, not your Ram. That fool couldn't do it then, and nobody could do it now. Duryodhan, my guru can't do it. Dronacharya cannot do it. I was born with this innate, let me say in today's language, genetic ability. I was born with that gift. You ever hear the singer say, I'm born with that. I didn't go and train. Nobody had teach me to throw salt in that shattering pond. I'm born with that gift. You find a reason to boast, you know. You find a reason to speak like that, you know. I was destined to win that beauty pageant. You see how I'm born? And the same girl, when her husband given, she turned her. I'm born for that too, Pandit. Careful where you're born with. Arjun now, when he said it, he says, oh brother, well then, he says, I want to see it. Imagine the play here. Watch how people could chain you up. Watch how people could make you doom your own self. Years ago, when I used to manage different plants, when I was working, the easiest management strategy to fire somebody. Nicholas, uncle, tell me. Don't quarrel with them, don't cuss them, don't get them letter, don't do that. No, you're going to fight. They will take it to court. They will want to fight you in labor law. Mm-mm, don't do that. Give them rope. And let them do it to themselves. You want to fire somebody? Give them a promotion. And you feel you could do it? And you is the boss. Do it. When you go and you fail. But now you fail in your new job. And when you fail, brother, we can't take that back. Fail is fail. Loss is loss. And when you fail, dog better than you. Hanuman is encouraging the monster inside of this man. True, I've never seen such a feat. Could you show me? Could you demonstrate that? He says, of course, put me to test. Test it. And I bet you, I will win. He says, okay, let's make a bet. If you make that bridge, if you cross from here to Lanka with that bridge. He says, no. That's too far. It'll take too long. Look, on the side of the Mandir, last night we talked about Hanuman Kund. On the side of Rameswar Jyotirlingam, on the outside of that temple, a huge pond, man-made pond, where people go to wash the foot before they come into the temple. Let's go and span just the pond, not a whole sea, just the pond. If you could just do it so I could see it, but I'm so excited. Sitara, I am so excited to see you do it, brother. If you do it, I promise I'll protect you for the rest. I am Hanuman.
I am that one who saves Lakshman by lifting his Jeevan herb. Have you heard of that discourse? He says, yes, I've heard from about my brother. Beam told me about the incident with you. I've heard that. He says, you promise you'll protect me? I say, yes. He says, but, if I win, what will I get? I say, ask for what you want. Anything you want, I am not going to lose. I cannot lose. This is a match I cannot lose. Anything you want. He says, okay, if you lose, I will go and collect all the driftwood on the beach. Make a nice big pyre. Hanuman, Hanuman, your god. Hanuman, Arjun, make a big pyre. Stand up in the pyre and burn yourself alive. Verse 24, chapter 18, and Anand Khan. Burn yourself alive because of your mouth, because of your character, because of the monster you are, because of a false pride, because of this demon you have inside of you. Burn it. Burn it if you're lost. Deal, but if you feel you can win, no problem, right? Arjun still, he spell out for you to catch, for you to hear and heed the person telling you, you're sure you want to gamble all your money? You're sure that is not something you're going to regret? You're sure? You're sure you could bet that money? Yes. This time I'm going to win. This time my name mark on that quick pick. This is it. It coming now. It coming. This is the one. This one. Hanuman says, if you're sure, let me go. Let me go. Tadapada karamaye chitapada. Peenak swarna ye gyanta. Puna puna ye prana de gyatam. Purva taksha ye brishta. Jaya bhole baba tab sharna.
Jaya
bhole baba tab sharna.
Jaya
sambha sada shiva tab sharna. Hanuman Baba, stand up. Talking to Lord Shiva. What's going to happen next now, Prabhu? And Arjun really stand up and he start to shoot arrow. But one thing people who have false pride in, they do, one trait. They don't believe in prayers. They don't believe in the necessity of prayer. Now, let me explain that. I could do puja. I could put on the clothes, offer the parasad, erect the flag, share food, and never believe, not one day, in what I'm doing. I'll do it like a parrot, like a machine. My wife tell me to do it, so I'm doing it, Baba. Think about the real test now, when the person jumping in the car. To put a flower sometimes real hard, you know. When you're by yourself and nobody can judge you except your God. Everybody in the office believe in putting some deity, some God, some divinity to protect you in the office. Except for the person who don't believe that I need that with me today. The person who has to dig the hole and bury the post hole. Where is the post hole? Which post hole will just dig first when we bless in the house? Northeast corner. You see where it come from? Vastu Sastra. Start that post hole in the northeast corner. Put the different metal, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, others, live inside the post. So that when the house make, you're inside the walls. When I bow in my house, I bow because God live here. But when I reach in my front door, I just bow and say, Sitaram, everybody. Not everybody believe in bowing to the front door. But you see the day when Pandit Anup come, Jai Jagadish Hari. I'll show everybody I could arti. That day I could show you how to do arti, Papa. On a normal day, I can't do that. On a normal day, I cannot reach my majandi to offer dar. The day when it's just you and your Hanuman, that day, that is necessary. Then you will know if the person believe in it or not. If you believe in something, you understand the importance of it. Remember, you didn't understand tonight in the little test.
in the little evaluation. You didn't understand the importance of your flag. Else it about it. Because in front of everybody, pundit and up, and we go the man. Bless it for me. Remember that. Learn to analyze and check yourself. One day, we have to meet God. And when God asks you, what did you do with this 60, 70, 80 years I give you? You have to account for it. Sometimes, when you see hardship coming in your life, you want to know where it's coming from. And you could be making a mistake and you have seen it. Arjun is making a mistake right now. He's building bridge. And Papa, I believe in God, he there shooting arrow. Apache and cowboy happening, he's shooting arrow. You have to stop to say a mantra. Bill, bridge Bill. He says, oh friend, oh monkey. Look, you see it from this side of the cone to that side. A bridge really did make. Hanuman went on the side. He stood in the water on the side of the bridge. And he says, Jai Shri Ram. And tip, with the tip of the tail, touched the bridge. Psh, fall, mash up, splinters. Says, okay, friend, bridge break. Start to pick up wood. Time to dead. Start to light the fire. Time for you to go. Well, when you make a bet, you have to live by it. Arjun drop his head now and start to pick up driftwood from by the beach, and he start to make a pyre. One of the names that we use for Krishna, when you hear us singing Krishna the night, this child coming to Mridanga, Krishna Ekadasi Katha. For everybody's benefit, I wanted to read something that had a little Krishna in it. One of the benefits of Krishna, when nobody else's have mercy, when nobody will save the person, Krishna is known as Kripa Raj, the king of Kripa. Kripa is mercy. When Tulsi, and you know why we're doing Tulsi Puja by the baby? If Tulsi is so great, to understand the point, if Tulsi is so great, why isn't she a Murti Hindu? How come she there like a little bush? Then you remember the katha we did do for Ganesh Utsav. When she was a little girl, she went to beg Ganesh, I want to marry, and I see you, and I like you, you have to marry me. Ganesh said, mm-mm. Me, whatever little time God give me, I go in and focus on God. If I get married, I got to focus on wife. Me hear what? And she get vexed. She say, you scorn marriage. From today, you're going to become the main deity in all them weddings. So when you see the pundit blessing the wedding ring, the sindoor, Ganesh mantra, the yellow rice in the kyad when they go in with neuta, Ganesh mantra. He says, no problem, I accept it. She say, you're afraid where I go do? I is one wife, you're afraid where I go do? You'll get married to two. That is how we end up with Ridhian City because of this. Say, okay, no problem, I'll take that. He say, but you see how, and I summarizing obviously. Say, you see how you talk about you should marry me because I have a wonderful shape and slender size and figure and I am capable of making children for you. Rah, 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 rah. And she went off on that road. When a person like to bury the body and show the flesh and like to get people love and attention because of their physique, when you have a habit of burying your body, the karmic reaction, you hear about it when Krishna was dragging the mortar and the pestle and he went between the two trees, the two Ashwin Kumar, Nala and Kubara, they were naked in the water and the Muni sees them in the next life, go and become a tree, spread your hand wide and lay all the fruits for the lady, the chest, the private parts, let it be in the open. So God takes, we talk about how he does make woman and man, he takes the Jivatma, you wanted to go and play Juve and play naked? All right, take out the soul from the human body and in next life, Dudus Mango, Chuli Mango. Lay all the mango be on display now. What you couldn't keep out of modesty, private, go and let it be public now. Tulsi Devi gets a shrap. You wanted to advertise? Go and be born as a plant, a tree, and spread your hand then. She remains as a shrub because of it. But when she really cried, she catch herself same time and she say, oh God, if I remain as a tree, how I go find my way back to God? How I'll get back upliftment? He said, well, I was sitting here. If you ever see Ganesh Baba in blue clothes, I was sitting here praying to Krishna. And Krishna, out of everybody, is the form that is forgive. He does forgive quick. When Krishna come as the shaligram, wherever that shaligram is, your leaf will be imperative to that worship. In fact, all the devotees will need for purification, the tulsi leaf. The root is used in funeral. The sticks, when it dry, is used in havan. The flowers is used in any Devi puja or in Krishna mala or your Hanuman Jayanti puja where you're making mala for Krishna. Cut the tip. Not when it dry, ready to reproduce. When it green and it have the scent. Take that, make mala with it, like how it is make with the bundle of the dub grass, and put that for Hanuman Swami. But, he tells her, but never will you be welcome in my puja. So if you ever go, Nicholas, remember when we were doing the Ganesh Jag? No tulsi plant. This is why. So Krishna has this repertoire that when the worst sinner, the most delinquent person come by, he will forgive the person. He will feel sorry for them. He will want to help them. So now, Krishna has to save Arjun. Otherwise, Arjun is going to die. Let's hear what happens in this slok, where Krishna takes form quick to get between these two, because Hanuman is not going to stop. Hanuman is going to take the life of Arjun here. No, he has been instructed, and he is going to work. Shiva Om Shakti Om Hari Om Narayanaya Krishnaya
प्रहिबत सुखये कृतहम् द्वैज येना पूर्वा व्रतहर प्राणी नातब अर्जुना
नारायणाय Everybody help me sing tonight.
परमात्माय नमो
Krishna wants to save him. Guru is speaking to Shishya about this history in this text. And he says Krishna wants to save him. And even now, Krishna is not holding any grudge. Krishna does not hold him in mind. Krishna just, you're my friend, you're next to me, you're my companion, and still you are so blind. I must save you now. And he takes the form of Advaita. Advaita is a person who wears the janeu. The janeu, many people think, if you sitting here tonight think the Upanayan sanskar, the janeu sanskar, makes you a pundit, I want you to go and watch your Ram Murti where he's a kshatri, Krishna Murti where he's a vaish, Hanuman Murti where he's not even human, and tell me which one of them is a pundit. Your concept of janeu, the string on the chest, is wrong. When you're cutting the hair, when you're bowing the ears, Karna Veda Sanskar, when you're doing all these sanskars to purify the soul, it is to remove past sin. For that reason, when the person ties the janeu, in all castes, in all walks of life, it is to remove the accumulated sin from your past life. This is why they call them dwij, or twice born. You go in the prayers, you're going to hear the person say that when they accept the Gayatri Mantra, the person is now considered twice born, freed from accumulated sin. But foolish people, stupid people, bottom of the barrel, dregs of the dregs, get tied up with other people, and they think, oh, this make you a pundit now. You tie a string on your chest, and that means you master Gayatri, and you could bless somebody. When you accept the art of becoming Purohit to do prayer, you have to open certain mantras. When you accept the role of Vyas, you accept this. You see the Kanhawar?
you have to do a sanskar called Ved Aram. That is the one just before wedding. The pundit is asked to go and get to study Upanayan. And when the pundit finish studying out, the person who have a higher position gives him this kanhawar. Only that person is allowed to go on the Vyasasan to sit to read because of your teaching and your ability. Because of your merit, you are now ready to give explanation. That Ved Aram Sanskar is what makes you fit for somebody to wash your foot and do your prayers. It is the Gayatri Mantra that gives you the benefactor position, that when the person reaches by your house, wash the foot, sprinkle the water, Guruji talking, wash the foot quick before the prayer start. When the Vyas, wash the foot again, before you read, wash the foot, before you eat, when you don't eat, then you just go and wash your hand, and you'll see the pundit who know, sprinkling the water. From that person, because of the Gayatri, it doesn't have to be male alone, but the Gayatri is what brings the purification to the home. When the person who knows the value of these things does it, this is what they're playing for. Pundit, you come like my worker, you come to do a little seva for me. When you come, purify my house. I want my house come light, I want my house come clean before the prayers start. Wherever the dust of the Gayatri is sprinkled, unrested soul, unrighteous people cannot stay. Those things make you the pundit. Not a little string around your chest. Please understand the difference. Now, in this form, Krishna takes a young boy, only the janeu, and a loincloth hiding the private part. He comes and he starts to yell at Arjuna and Hanuman. Let's hear what happens.
Narayanaya Krishnaya
Paramatma Namo Namah.
Narayanaya Krishnaya
Paramatma Namo Namah.
Iti nishchal manasa kapidvij yeya so Arjuna vrathim jitaya tvam vatukyujanna sahasa chakra tu darshana.
Come on everybody, let me sing. Paramatma namo nama. Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatma namo nama.
He says, Oh, you smart men, what are you doing here? This is our place. This is like a pundit. Young boy training to be pundit. He says, this is our temple. This is our ground. What are you making fire and doing what? What are you doing here? What is this bridge? What are you building in our place? Hanuman with a smile says, young one, we had a bet. And he lost the bet. He had to build this bridge. But then look, it fell, and the little piece must remain. He says, look, it fall. And now, poor fella, he's building his pyre. He's building a chit to burn himself. If you stay, you will see, he will burn himself soon. Stay and watch. Watch what your mouth could put you in trouble. There's a lesson being learned today. You make sure and never go down this road. Krishan says, In the little boy form. He says, oh, great Vanar, oh, great warrior, hold up. According to Dharma, in every bet, in every wager, we have to have an impartial person. We have to have a witness. You are trying to outsmart this man. How do we know you're not thiefing him? And he could be a foolish guy. He could be making a foolish wager and lose. Let's do it over. If you are so confident to win, let's do it over.
Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah.
Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah.
Tvam Sahasraye Ramo Rama Rama Arjuna Ram Rupa Satya Rupyatam Vanara Hala Hala Dvejati.
Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah. Narayanaya Krishnaya
Hanuman says, I gladly accept your terms. Let's do it again. The outcome will be no different. Because of his ways, he's doomed to fulfill your desire. Let's do it. Friend, come, come. Try again. Try your hand. And let me see if this time if fate will be different. Hanuman stands up smiling. Arjun goes, he pulls the bow. But this time, the little boy, Krishna in disguise, says, friend, if I could give you a little piece of information, a little advice, do you realize you cannot do this work? You cannot do this task by yourself? You are about to lose your life. Be as humble to see the need and the necessity of your God. A person who is blinded by Abhiman could never see the need for God in his life. Call on him now. Call on your God now. See your God now. See the role, see the hole in your life. And when you put him in that hole, when you put him in the void, he will allow the road that has the biggest pothole, you will ferry straight over. Your bridge will stand strong and your life will be spared. Call on him now.
Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah. Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah.
Hanumat Hanumat Mahadvija Mahakapi Dvijaye Pratayatam Gira Yenat Yevanar Vanar Ram Ram Yeyati Narayanaya
Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah. Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo.
Shri Vishnu Bhagwan ki jai. So you know in your Indian movie when you're watching it, how you just see them pull the bow and they say in the prayers, your secret prayers, mantra. You just see the tasaman saying it over the sticks. You just see the person when they're blessing the puchara stick. When they're going wrong the pyre, the chit about the light, they just have a prayers. They just say, bless the stick that lighting, the stick that working. When the person who know what they're doing in the kitchen and they're blessing the utensils that they're about to cook with, bless we to get through. That's around the time they just take out the little seed half of the fire. In different ways, we just pray for those things. Don't be surprised, the Hindus put a murti in their car and put a Rudraksha in their car and put the Gita on their desk when they understand the value of their God. God, I need you here. I cannot drive if you don't wish it. I'll never reach where I'm going. For this reason, the Hindus put a Rudraksha. Last night we said this, when the tears of Shiva, when Sati Mata burning, the teardrop fall and that tree sprout. For that reason, wherever that bead is, one bead gives you the blessing of Shiva tomorrow. For the Pradosh, come, you'll collect one that comes from the Havan that are going to do tomorrow. Keep it in your wallet, keep it in your purse, and Shiva is standing there with you. But too often, me and you just have the Rudraksha in the car, boy, and we don't touch it until the day to sell the car now. Be honest with yourself. Time to build the bridge. He builds it the same way. Shoot arrow after saying his prayers. Calls on Krishna. He says, Krishna, you have to save me now. If you don't save me, I'm going to lose my life. Little boy Krishna there sends his Sudarshan Chakra for it to spin in the water. Unknown to anybody. He does his work. Bridge built. Hanuman takes the tail. Jai Shri Ram hits the bridge. Bridge didn't fall. Push the bridge. Bridge, I rock it. Then move. Stand up. Take the mukdar and drop one. Nothing. The Jai Shri Ram starting to get louder. Now, wondering, what is this? Hanuman himself jumps on top the bridge and starts to belabor that bridge with mukdar. But one of the siddhi of Hanuman, no matter what form Sri Ram is hiding,
he has the benefit to see the Lord and to see the work of God. Some people could see, for example, you see that car battery there this morning? As inconvenient as it is, maybe I would have met my death on that road today. You know? That happened for a reason. I just pray God every day bless me. And sometimes something has to slow you down so you don't meet your death in an accident. Not everybody have that drishti. Not everybody have that vision. Oh God, God, let this tire get flat. God, I had exam, I had this, I had that. Go and meet your debt and see how much exam you can write. Hanuman is of the cloth. He comes from that fabric that wherever Sri Ram is hiding, wherever Sri Ram is playing, wherever his Leela is unfolding, wherever his hand is working, Hanuman has the drishti to see it. So he sees the motive behind the Leela. And he says, I feel my Lord is here. Verse 45. I feel my Prabhu is here. And when he watched on his side, he's looking for Prabhu now. Left and right at the bridge, he see the representative of Vishnu, the Sudarshan Chakra, big in the water, spinning. That represents Mahavishnu. That Sudarshan Chakra comes from Lord Shiva. If you ever heard that discourse, where does Lord Vishnu get it? Lord Shiva, bless him. You hold this and you go and save people with it. That was the words he says, Shiv Puran. So Lord Vishnu holds it in the murti of all the weapon, sword, cutlass, bow and arrow. Mahavishnu holds on to the gift that Lord Shiva gives him. Hanuman Baba knows that this represents Lord Vishnu. And when he lifted his head, and he watched to the shore of the pond, Arjun, yes. But when he watched, he see the little boy blink, and then he sees Ram. He says he sees the form he was grieving to see. In the Surya River, in the Ram, in the past age, remember this is a whole age now, you know. Ram, leave the earth, leave Hanuman, Chiranjeevi, you live here. One day I will come to look for you. One day I will play with you. And a whole janam pass. There's a text called Hanuman Ramayana where Hanuman writes the first Ramayana and he destroys it when Valmiki writes his Ramayana. And Hanuman goes to listen to Valmiki. Anytime this text reading, Hanuman comes to hear because it is the authentic text, the first text written by Valmiki. Hanuman loves this version of Ramayana. Hanuman is waiting for an inkling, an iota of Sri Ram. And when he watches and he sees the bow holding Prabhu Sri Ram, you wait for your whole life to see something like this. And your gods come now to give you darshan. Maybe in dream you see him. If you have the blessing of the Lord, maybe for people who believe in Sai Baba and the pity I start to give vibhuti, like when I was singing Sai Shankar, when that pity I start to show you, listen, are real. When Amrit starts to flow from the pity and it make you think, wow, what is this boy? Wood pity and something is bleeding coming out of the pity. When your Ganesh started to drink the milk and you started to wonder how? Just how? Just answer how. Within yourself, this don't make sense. I don't understand what my eye is showing me. How did you react? In the moment, in your dream, you're seeing him and he's saying, Leela girl, how you going? It's your going, and he's talking to you. That sweet rice you make, I really enjoy it, 100 marks. Thank you for that. And that personal meeting happening. And you're seeing the big murti. And you know, when we sit down to do prayers, we just have God, I want the lotto to win. And I want my husband to stop drinking. And my son don't talk to me. I want him to talk to me back. And he just come with the checklist. But now you're really meeting him. It's real. I don't know your experience. I don't know if God bless you with that moment yet. God bless you. You're going to get it. Somehow you just get I can't say a word. That time, just like Hanuman, you just started watching toe. Padma Sevanam is where you love that foot of the Murti. I only like to put all the flowers by his feet. I worship his feet, the feet of God, the feet of the Guru, is the feet of my parents, is where the dust day and the Gayatri blessings is come. So Hanuman always train him, mother never teach him, bow by Sri Ram's elbow, bow by Sri Ram's shoulder, all is Sri Ram, think what I'm saying. But here you know you just come to prayers, but you just only bow by foot, bow by your mother foot. When you go and the prayers finish, pon it and up, where we just drink? Chana Amrit. And I will just call it Chana Amrit. No? Punch Amrit. Punch Amrit, five liquid. Punch Amrit. But when it done, Tanti, Aji, Nani, and all, let us call it something else. Chulha Amrit, something? No. Charan. Charan, like Charan bookstore. Charan. What is Charan? The ankle to the toe, that region of your body, that is your charan. When you wash the shaligram, you are washing the foot of God. And then you will see the Baba catch it back in the cup. And now it becomes purifying. It has the ability to wash away sins. It has a way. Why do you drink the little drop of milk? So that the sin that is causing internal sickness now. Because when I bow to the foot of the Murti, I point it here and I'll pass it on my hair, malju, najar, skin problem, go. But when you have cancer inside, bro, you have to get something inside to fix it. So maybe some people just take aspirin, but the Hindu aspirin is Charan Amrit. When you see the Hindu get a prasad is anything he touch. Don't say Mahanbog. Mahanbog, but then you just get fig, you're only making barfi every night, you're getting all type of thing. Prasad is anything he touched, start touching it to my head and my heart. And you see Nicholas is telling it, Jai Jai Sitaram, open your prasad and share it, it have benefit. All this is happening. And Hanuman sees Sri Ram for the moment, and in that moment he starts to cry. He starts to howl, the monkey, the genetic, the base in the person. You ever see a person howl in a funeral? If I do it right now, when I was small, when we was children, our neighbor, you know it has some people could bawl good in a funeral? She was blessed with that. She, in my opinion, till this day, I don't know if you like this, she could have been a professional funeral bawler. You could have hired this lady to bawl. And I said, trouble she, because she used to jump and whoop, and go like that. Hanuman does the same thing. I'm saying it for children to understand. If me and you see that Murti come alive, we might be the fastness in we will, okay, I close we eye. You have to see him. Some people will tell you that. I cannot afford to close my eye when I'm doing prayers. I want to keep my eye on him. But the person understand why they don't want to close the eye. But it have inside some people, I just want to see where this one went and where that one went. So I can't close my eye when I say in prayers. So it could have different reasoning. Hanuman, so overcome with emotion, he couldn't say words. He couldn't say Ram. He couldn't say the name. He couldn't say, Prabhu, look over here. He couldn't do it. He started to squeal. He started to hop. The monkey in him started to show through. And in that screaming, howling type of breath, he says, Prabhu, the inner person. Forget about Arjun now. Forget about Shiva now. Forget about work. Forget about everything now. Now was his moment, because now his Prabhu appeared. Blink again and disappear. He sees Krishna. But Hanuman knows the story of Mahavishnu, so he knows what Krishna represents. He run from on the bridge. Imagine the speed the son of the wind is moving. And he's with the force, mash brakes, and he's skating coming in and drops his head by the little boy. Why the little boy? Because Arjun said, I'm next to a little boy, and that's all he could see. He doesn't have the drishti to see the truth. And in an insulting tone, even now, he says, Hanuman, what are you doing? This is the same boy you was talking to. Why are you crying? Now he's washing the foot. You have to understand what's happening here. He's seeing Ram. He's seeing Krishna. And all the offering he has to Masawe, the foot, is the teardrops. He says, Prabhu, allow me to do your seva after all this time. When the Padma Sevanam come, when the person come and you see the lota water on the side of the murti, the person who know what they're doing is wash your toe. They don't go and wash elbow. You ever catch yourself washing the fingers of God? But the sevak knows what I come to do. I come to wash your foot and take the dust from the foot to my forehead. Purify me. Understand why it is bow like that. Understand why it is do it. The dust from that murti foot could save me from my trouble. Please understand. Hanuman is not studying what this stupid blind boy Arjuna is saying now. He says, oh friend, how dotish, how dumb, how blind you really could be. You are standing next to him and you do not realize who he is. How could you be so blind and be the best friend of Vishnu incarnate Krishna? And when Krishna was ready, when Kriparaj was ready for Arjun, when Arjun blinks, then the little boy became Krishna. And when Arjun, you could imagine, he shocked, he doubted himself. Blink again, he says, Ram. Blink again, Krishna come back. Now Arjun ready to bow. Now Arjun knows what to do because you look like the God I worship. I could respect you, yeah. When Arjun drops his head, Krishna tells him, it is time for you to change. The demon of your character has to change. You have to conquer the demon inside of you. Otherwise, you will never win. You will lose. If you want to win, win and conquer the battle inside of you first. Arjun, with humility, realizing his wrong, takes the lesson. Krishna now turns to Hanuman. Can't remember how to sing this thing, you know. You're going to have to help me. Everybody, last verse, put your hand together. Krishna is talking to Hanuman here.
Suno Hanuman Baba, Suno Hanuman, Suno Hanuman Baba, Suno Hanuman. Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama, Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama.
Everybody.
Time for you to keep up your word and protect this boy. This boy is getting ready for a big battle, and only you could stand with them. Only you could protect them. We need your protection, O warrior, O great servant of Vishnu in the form of Ram. Please do us the service of protecting your children. Wherever they call upon you, wherever they need you, wherever they put you, take a form that we will always have you. No matter how bad the times get, no matter how sinful the Kaliyuga becomes, always allow that form that you take to be most powerful. Hanuman says, I remember my conversation with Bhim. And as I said it then, I'll say it now. In the form of the Kapi Dwaj, in the form of the flag of my form, in the red form. Why is it red? It's red because of the solar energy, the tej, the fire, the force of Surya Narayan Swami makes red his color. The color of Tuesday, the planet Mars, that is his day. Mangal is the son of Shiva, that planet red because of the pain of Shiva. When he started to cry and Mangal is formed, he's born with temper, with rage. And that red color, because he's close to Mother Earth. Hanuman is pegged on the Tuesday because of that discourse. The red flag, he says, I will live in that flag. And wherever that flag is flying above, I will protect there. When you mount your chariot, put me above you, go home and watch the copy of your Gita book. On top of that chariot comes Hanuman Baba. He says, I will give you all my protection. On that entire side, wherever, whichever house, whichever battle, whichever place that Hanuman flag is flying, I will reign, I will protect. Wherever or which person has that red flag over their head, that protection that you are praying for, I will give it to them or to those people that are looking for it. You understand why that red flag has value in your life? Then when you get your red flag home, and you're trying to get it taller than the bow char. You're trying to let the red flag be higher than the roof. It's taller than the rest of the flag. Jay, what that flag mean? It means victory. Victory over what? Victory over what Hindu? It starts with me, with all my bad habits, with all my addiction. Hanuman Baba, help me. Protect this house from argument. Protect this house from thief. Protect this house from bandit. Bless me in the battle. Every day I'm fighting a battle on that roadway. Bless me to win. Where you feel the politicians sit down in the back. Go when you see all the ministry have flag flying. Flag flying red, black, red, white, and black. By all them ministry office. You ever see how it is decorate with flag? With a little triangle like this blowing, they want to make sure their colors reign. Make sure you reign supreme. When you go in the fete and you see everybody waving their flag, when you go in the cricket match waving their flag, what is the logic? I want to win. That flag is pegged with the winner. The bigger the flag, more you're going to win. Not so? More flag you have and more vote you're going to get. Not so? The flag comes from your Hanuman. But the one place you're supposed to have your flag, Shiv Baba Hai flag, the 9 flag, the 64 flag, the 9 flag way outside in front of your house, that flag. When you come to do your prayers, Baba, leave that flag. Left that flag, they may go and lift that flag. Shame if Uncle Sima lift that flag. Then you become Arjun. Then you become the enemy in your life. Hanuman is waiting to give you that protection from the bandit that is waiting for you. Imagine it, have people plotting, watching you, and you hear the people went in the temple to sleep for the jag, and bandit come and well deal with them. You know how much people gonna say Hanuman let that happen? And God let it happen? If they have a way for we to protect ourselves tonight. If you never knew the value of your red flag, why your red flag is be taller? If you're going on the temple and you see the temple had the red flag over the temple. If you see that flag, like you come home by me, you see the flag over the house. Hanuman Baba, you reign supreme here. Where's the tail end of this discourse? Mahabharat have it. When the war is finished, Mahabharat was done. And they're getting ready to crown Yudhishthira king. Duryodhan is dead. Krishna come off the chariot, no problem, everything good. Arjun, you come off, no problem, everything good. Hanuman, come off that flag, come. When Hanuman comes off the entire chariot of Arjun burns, destroy. All the arrow, all the hit, all the missile, everything that was hitting them, it now all the marks show up. Yahashanigra, do Hanuman Puja. You have shiny problem, do Hanuman prayers on a Saturday. When you have gra, when you have different problem, when you have somvat, when you have eye problem, everybody have cataract, everybody have glaucoma, do Hanuman prayers with the 5 head. When you have children that not listening, do Hanuman prayers with the 8 dash, the 11 head form. Do your Hanuman prayers and he will become your savior of all the devtas that you have. It have 8 form of Lakshmi. It have 14 form of Bhairo. It have different avatar of the form. How come only Hanuman is the hero? Hanuman of all the flag is the one who is positioned to save you. Save you from yourself. Save you from the outside enemy. Save you from Ravan. Save you from Kans. Save you from if the hair curly, if the hair straight, you name it. Hanuman could deal with it. It's just sometimes you and I shame the holy flag. Sometimes you and I take pride in saying, we are no the Hanuman Chalisa. You want to test yourself? You bring flowers tonight for him. You bring your tulsi leaf for him. Ask yourself if you're feeling. This life is about tests. Hanuman is the person utilized by the teacher, Lord Shiva, to test Arjun. But in life, realistically, we are tested every God living day. Every day you make it to work, every day you make it home. Thank you, God. If you are the right thinking, thank you, God. God, I bow into the earth, I step out the house. God, I touch any tree, I'm moving. God, I pick your flowers, go with me in a car. Because I realize I could try to drive normal, but one got you on the road and I wouldn't reach. Then you're being honest with yourself. Because we just tell children, say a prayer before you do the examine. But oh, how much all it is bow to the flag when you leave in the house? How much all you have him over your door? Be honest with yourself tonight. Lift your flag and wave your flag a little bit. Just make sure you over your head. That's the purpose of that flag. Lift your flag. Come on.
Suno Hanuman Baba. Suno Hanuman.
Suno Hanuman Baba. Suno Hanuman.
Bajranga Bali. Bajranga Bali. Bajranga Bali. Hanuman.
Hanuman Baba, tonight, stand up over my head the way they stand up over Arjun. And you see when the bandit come in, stand up over me. And they say when you stand up with Bhim, and Bhim was bawling in the heart of Duryodhan, all so much of fear, so much of fright, that Duryodhan couldn't remember his guru mantra. He couldn't remember his prayers, his secret formulas that he could have called on the Mukhtar. Duryodhan forget it and he said it's time, I'll late, let me rush to the battlefield. And that caused Duryodhan to fail. That if somebody call you the enemy gets fearful. The enemy gets frightful. So much so you will hear the person say, see me? Man, don't study them people. Me a bother in them people. They have funeral. You ever see somebody stand up outside and they dare not come inside at that place where that funeral doing? You ever see somebody doing a wedding where the poor fix the go around the kalash, where the people name inside the kalsa? But the lady who wanted to marry the boy, no pun on the say. The person with jealousy, the person with jealousy dare not come inside the mandap and not go into that wedding. They're cutting the child, Mundan Sanskar, they're cutting that child here and go by collecting the hair. I cannot go there. It have a prayer that is chant for Hanuman to stand up like the guardian over the doorway. It have a reason for that red flag. When you put it on the four-way on the junction, when you put it in front of your property, when people, long time people, is to understand, praying for your place, praying for your village. My neighbor house can be burning down and my house be all right. When the Hindu pray, we pray for all. We pray for all and we pray for everybody. Tonight, if you didn't understand Hanuman, if you didn't understand your flag, make sure you understand it now. Tonight, that's in your hand. Pound it down, bless it, and you call God, God in your hand. Sing for Hanuman a little bit. We're going to finish now. All the beauty.
Suno Hanuman Baba. Suno Hanuman.
Suno.
Believe.
Jai
Jai
Bolo
Sing.
Hanuman Ki
Shri Ram Lakshman Janaki Jai Bolo Hanuman Ki Jai Bolo Hanuman Ki Shri Ram Lakshman Janaki Jai Bolo Hanuman Ki Bajranga Bali Baj If you believe in him, sing Hanuman Bajranga Bali Bajranga Bali Hanuman Suno Han Everybody Oh Baba Pavana Putra Hanuman Ki Tonight, as I conclude, again, forgive me for going over. Are you enjoying all the satsang? Are you learning about your Hanuman? Don't walk away from this Yagyashala. Don't do it. These people slaving to cook. God bless every cook. People who contribute cash and kind. People who made this possible. The poor person who get to sweep this tile. They're doing it so you and I could learn. This is Gyan Yagya. When you get the invite next time and you hear Vishnu Gyan Yagya, Lakshmi Gyan Yagya, understand what is Gyan. Gyan is the knowledge that takes me closer and better to my God. We could sit down and sing whole night, trust me. Trust me, if I wanted to flip the page and let me go, we could read and I would hold your attention till 12 o'clock. You wouldn't believe we could go whole night. Your Hanuman have so much discourse. He does. If we go and sit down to wonder why we just offer jasmine oil or the orange Hanuman sindur or the tulsi leaf as we talk about, how does Sita Mata and Tulsi get so close? There are many discourses. We have started to scrape Hanuman yet. Think we are seeing. But in the few discourses so far, tomorrow night is our last night, in the few discourses we have touched on, do you realize how much room we have to improve? Don't study. Don't make the mistake like Arjun. Don't make the mistake like the people who watch the guy up the road turning around the pit here or have the week in an example. And watch what them doing and I doing it because he doing it. I don't know why. I don't want to learn about my Hanuman. Mm-mm. Don't make that mistake anymore. If you make it, God forgive me. Tonight I'll learn something. Tonight I carry it home, that flag is yours. Carry it home and put it up proudly by your front. Put it up in the children's room when they're crying, when it could be inside the house. Imagine you live in a country where the HDC or counselor, the HDC just tell you you cannot put up any structure to the front of your house. Understand where that come from. There's only one religion that's built religious structures to the front of their house. You cannot build kutia. You cannot put the enclosure where they put jandi, where the banister. Imagine somebody build a little concrete. I think I could be corrected on this part. I think up to 2 years. But long after, you'd bless your house the first time. For many reasons, you will see Hindu people who have HDC houses or apartments cannot put up their flags or these things that the Mahasabha agreed on in my best memory in 1956. Our dharma is always on the attack. And you could be the weakest link, or you could be the strongest link. Your God is capable. Your God is strong. Your dharma, the principles by which you live. When somebody says, I am Sanatan Dharma. When in your marriage certificate, you don't put Hindu, you know. Sanatan Dharma. Sanatanist. A follower of Sanatan Dharma. It have nothing called Hindu. Hindu mean the people live by the Hindu river, to put it simple. That is like saying my religion, I'm a, how you say, Barapuranian, Penalarian. That is what it is say when you say I'm a Hindu. Look at how we just get it wrong. The proper name of our faith is Sanatan Dharma, or a list of principles by which I live by. There's so much we could talk about. It's only five nights. It's only, when you watch it like that, it's only five nights. And this is why I keep this bad pundit, only had these people suffering, going late. And I apologize, genuinely apologize. But I hope by the end of our yug, I hope you and your Hanuman could get a little Inca closer. That is my objective. Everybody, Pawana Putra Hanuman Ki. Artie, Nick, Artie, or it have anybody to say anything? I know we're drawing to the end. You want to tell me the plan, any plan or anything with tomorrow? Shani Pradosh, I know we have special prayers tomorrow chanted. You hear what you say? Wait, Sitaram.
Sitaram. So Pandit Anup is reminding us that tomorrow is Shani Pradosh. And for those of us who would like to participate in that activity, I think over the last few nights we spent a lot of time sharing the importance of that activity tomorrow from 10 o'clock. Pandit Anup will be, you have the opportunity to come from 10 o'clock with your Hawan Kund. We will put a diya in the Hawan Kund in an effort not to create as much smoke. And then we will burn it out after. And the ingredient for tomorrow is urdi. Yeah? Black urdi. So your Hawan Kund, diya, your mango wood, a camphor, ghee, and your urdi. And that starts what time, Baba? From 10 o'clock, 10 to 2, Baba will be here. Yeah. And your prasad. So the prasad, Baba would have told us that any fruit with plenty seed. Yeah? So make it very easy for you. Any fruit with plenty seed to make your offering tomorrow. That's one. Two, we have a lot of devotees listen to Baba and they brought flowers. They brought...
Is he already laughing?
Yeah.
He doubted me that people would bring flowers. That's why he laughing. So thank people, you for proving him wrong. Everybody give yourself a clap. I love that.
So the flowers and all the puja artifacts are at the feet of Hanuman Baba. So after we do closing arati, you all have an opportunity to go and do your arati and make your offerings, whatever your heart desires. I just want to share a quick story. Maybe just over 10 years ago, Aunty Shirley had planned a yagna with Pandit Keshava. And then she booked a flight and she went away. This is a true story. We were talking about this last night. Whatever the reason was, she had to go away. She called me. I think I was in UWE, I think it was.
Yeah, UWE.
She called and she said, yeah, Nick, we planned this yag and it's starting. I think it was less than a month time. And she had to go. And she came back the second to last day before the yag finished. And at that time, we had a youth group. We were just kickstarting our operations and so on, you know. And we were coming down, but we were not so engrossed in Sanatan Dharma. And I, thinking back now, I was so angry with Anishali then. How irresponsible of her to plan this yag and leave and go and leave us, you know, to carry on this. But we did.
Quite
that
well.
Was a successful yajna. And over a decade later, 10 years later, I think we could all see the fruits of that. We have so many young people and so many families that support this mandir, that support all of our activities. And Baba said it a short while ago, people come and they slave. But I want to say they serve in any form or any fashion. And this yagna, in a week time, things fell in place. And we never had to worry. My uncle say, he says, so how things come along? I say, well, ego come.
Ego come.
I was just never worried. And it really unfolded in such a way where we wish we had more nights. The 5 nights seem so short. And we can't be grateful enough for all of your support and all of your efforts over the last couple of nights. And not only the last couple of nights in supporting Sanat and Dharma in this mandir. We could have been anywhere else. We could have been waving our flag anywhere else tonight. And on that note, we have a commitment from a devotee that they are going to prepare some more flags for tomorrow.
Very good.
Because they enjoy the flag waving. And I also think we all appreciate that purpose of the flag and what it represents in our lives as Sanatanas Hindus now. So I hope that we always keep our flags flying high for all of the right reasons. Yeah, refreshments have been provided for everyone. So please stay back after Aarti. And we look forward to tomorrow. I heard you mention Hawan tomorrow. So is that what you said?
Tell me where you're here. Rudraksha. Oh, tomorrow, right. What I was talking about, I am doing my personal job, Hawan home. But from that Hawan with the basma or the ashes, it has a little benefit. When you see people putting ash on their body, it comes from the Hawan. I will give whoever is here a Rudraksha bead. You'll come by me and with the mantra in your hand, you'll collect it. So tomorrow night, just like how you collect that flag, you know, little children like when they go to trade show and thing, they just get a little free pen and free stuff. We like that free stuff, you know. It's a little encouragement. Here comes a little prayer stuff that you put in your wallet or your purse.
I was going to say, if there's any activity that you want to have a more interactive we could do
some of the Hawan here. We all think, all they want to do it? All come on, all that answer. Everybody want to do Hawan, a little we'll cut and fit some time and we'll do a little job. Sound good? This little fella said yes. So we'll do it, right? Nothing too long.
Sitaram, everybody.
Sitaram. Everybody, let's all stand as we've run out of time a little while now. If you have your flowers, if you came in late, if you feel strongly about your Hanuman Murti, and you want to go and put your flowers with your own two hands or touch your Murti, your home, this is home. Go and take the opportunity and stop this thing with shaming and shaming. Nobody are going to tell you nothing if you go and do arti. Rather than waste the strength that God give you right now, I invite everybody to go and put your hand, light, wave your light by some Murti, anyone you want. Feel free. Sajam cha varti sanyuktam grahina yojitam mayam deepam grahana devesham trailokya timidapaham
jai jagadish hari swami jai jagadish hari
Om Jai Jagadish.
Jada, everybody.
Swami Jai Jagadish Hare. Last Jano Ki Sangat, Chas Jano Ki Sangat, Chan Me Dur Hare. Om Jai Jagadish Hare.
Just take a second and close your eyes if you're in the audience in particular. When you have a moment with him, and you have a divine moment with him, like how Hanuman saw Sri Ram, the person starts to feel very weak. You start to feel empty because all the negative is flowing to the earth. Your body is growing off and the energy is going. A lot of his prayer, when it is done properly, you start to feel empty, you start to feel tired, you see children sleeping, you see elders bepping on the shelf, and people wonder why. Because the moment is taking all the uncontrolled energy out of you.
सुनो हनुमान बाबा, सुनो हनुमान, सुनो हनुमान बाबा, सुनो हनुमान। If tears came to your eyes, if emotion came to your heart, if you found yourself busy talking to yourself, I need to do better, then this prayers was effective. Then it worked. Then the katha save Arjun and you from becoming the worst enemy in your day-to-day life. Let's say our prayers now that we finish. Ask for his blessing. Twameva Mata, everybody.
Sapita Twameva.
Twameva Bandusha.
Sapa Twameva.
Twameva Vidya.
Dravinam Twameva.
Twameva Sarvam.
Mama Deva Deva.
Twameva Sarvam.
Mama Deva Deva.
Together. Om Shanti. Everybody.
Shanti.
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 Lift your hand now. If you have your flag, lift your flag. Now you name man. Now we understand. Pawana putra numaneki. Pawana putra numaneki. Pawana putra numaneki. Siyabara Ramachandra ki. Umapati Mahadeva ki. Shri Adi Shakti Mata ki. Vindra Vandi Harilala ki. Satya Sanatan Dharma ki. Jai. Jai Jai. Sitaram. Sitaram, everybody.